This is Paul. Paul has been producing trance music for many years. His friends told him to use more compression to improve his mixdown. Paul already knows that a compressor reduces the difference between the loudest and the quietest part of a signal by lowering the loudest sounds while keeping the silent sounds as they are. The result is a clean and loud mix that's more comfortable to listen to. So he decided to add a compressor on almost every sound without knowing how to use it. Let's help Paul setting up his compressor properly. The most important control is the threshold. It sets the level at which the compressor starts working. Peaks that are louder than the threshold are going to be affected by compression. A compressor usually comes with an envelope containing two main controls. Attack controls how quickly the compressor starts reducing the volume after reaching the threshold. And release controls how fast the compressor is going to stop reducing the volume after the signal drops below the threshold. You should choose a short attack in order to lower transients and peaks of your signal. If you want the compressor to leave the transients, it's better to choose a longer attack. Another optional setting in a compressor is the ratio control. It determines how much the compressor will reduce the volume. Paul also heard about multiband compression. This simply means that a compressor can be set up for a specific frequency band. So if you only want to compress low frequencies, or you want your compressor not to react to your baseline, it's better to use a multiband compressor. Of course, there is more to say about features and different types of compressors, but let's leave it at that for the moment. Paul is ready to adjust his compressors now. Please like and subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more Psytrance production related videos. Also check my own Psytrance production and mastering service that you can find in the description.